as I grab the Glock. Put it to your headpiece, one in the chamber. The safety is off, release straight at your dome homes. I wanna see cabbage.
What's good? It's the one and only NY Phenom. Welcome to the fire range. We line up and get lined up. You understand me? Listen, my next target, my next victim, is these overrated, good for nothing, waste of space Kansas City Chiefs. Hear me out, Kansas City Chiefs fans. You guys ain't shit. Y'all ain't shit. I don't want to hear nothing about this previous Super Bowl. Okay? It doesn't change the fact that Andy Reid's a choker. That fat ass is a choker. Tyreek Hill is a bad person. And Patrick Mahomes is not the best quarterback in the NFL. Listen, Chiefs fans. Y'all can come in my comments, talk all this shit y'all want. Y'all are just as irrelevant as the Cleveland Browns. Alright, for real. What's the difference between Cleveland Browns and the Kansas City Chiefs? Y'all are just as big as a disgrace. For real. All these Chiefs fans want to come in my comment section, talk about, we got Mahomes, and we got Tyreek Hill, and we got Andy Reid. We're going to win the division, and we're the best team. You don't know nothing about football. Well, listen, I got news for you, Chiefs fans. Y'all don't have the best team in the division. Matter of fact, y'all got so upset, and when I wasn't even bashing y'all. I gave you guys just constructive criticism. I give you guys constructive criticism saying the Denver Broncos going to this year was a better overall team. You guys couldn't take it. You guys got your panties in a bunch. You guys want to come at me, the phenomenal one, and come with all the insults. Well, I got more news for y'all. Not only the Denver Broncos are better than the Kansas City Chiefs, the LA Chargers are a better team than the Kansas City Chiefs. The LA Chargers are a better overall team than the Kansas City Chiefs. Suck it, Chiefs fans. Suck my fucking dick, yo. I hope it's all the way down your throat. Go take another one. As a matter of fact, while my dick is down your throat, go drink some bleach. For real. Go drink some bleach. And, you know, if that's not enough, go get a knife and just, like, start, just start rubbing it on your wrist. For real. Y'all Chiefs fans can burn. Y'all can burn an acid. Okay, I was just showing the Denver Broncos some love just because I think they were one of the up-and-coming, young, great teams in the NFL, and you guys couldn't take it. You guys want to call me a donkey Broncos fan. Well, I could care less about the Broncos. I'm not a Broncos fan. Never cared for them. I'm a Seahawks fan. I talk shit about the Broncos in the past. Okay, I still like to, rub it in on Broncos fans about that 2013 Super Bowl when we blew Peyton Manning out 43-7. But at the end of the day, you Chiefs fans be out of pocket, out of line. Just because I said Drew Locke is going to put MVP numbers up with Cortland Sutton and Jerry Jeudy and KJ Hamler, and they got Melvin Gordon and Phillip Lindsay. Okay, you Chiefs fans can live in y'all delusional world where you guys got your Super Bowl and you guys think that y'all finna go back to back, but it's not happening. You know, ESPN had the audacity to say that the Kansas City Chiefs have the best chances to win the upcoming Super Bowl. The ESPN and all these sports betting people talking about how the Chiefs have the best odds to win the Super Bowl. Well, I got news for you. You guys aren't repeating. Okay, you guys are not going to sniff a chance to win back-to-back Super Bowls. This is not happening. Okay? Like I said, you got two teams in your own division that's better than y'all. The Ravens are better than y'all. The Ravens got better. They added Calais Campbell, Derek Wolfe. They dropped their linebacker. They got that stud-ass secondary. Lamar Jackson is going to come back with vengeance. Okay, they got J.K. Dobbins. Okay, Miles Boykin is going to turn into a really good receiver. You guys aren't better than the Ravens. You guys aren't better than the Steelers. You guys aren't better than the, honestly, to be honest with y'all, I might pick the Colts to be better than y'all. For real. Because the Colts got Phillip Rivers. Okay, who we've seen that can compete with Patrick Mahomes. Plus, Phillip Rivers is working with mad talent down there in Indiana. So, overall, you guys aren't a top team in the AFC. You guys just are going off of one Super Bowl. Off of one lucky Super Bowl run. Okay, you guys face the Texans. You face Bill O'Brien and Texans. And you guys beat Ryan Tannehill and Derrick Henry to get to the Super Bowl. Congratulations. You won the cookie? Okay, but I got news for you. if you guys were to face Foxborough, if you guys were to face the Patriots, you guys would have lost. You guys weren't going to beat the Patriots again. I got news for you. It would have been 2018 all over again. Okay, because Stephon Gilmore, Jason McCourty, Devin McCourty, Patrick Chung, they were locking all that Patrick Mahomes, Andy Reid offense bullshit up. And they were going to do it again. Okay? I mean, come on now. You guys got lucky. Lucky Super Bowl run. Okay, you guys didn't have to face the Patriots. Okay, if you guys were to face the Patriots, you guys would have lost. And it would have been no Super Bowl last year. So you guys should be lucky that you guys had the easy roll to the Super Bowl. Okay, and then y'all want to talk about beating the 49ers. Listen, Kyle Shanahan and the 69ers and Jimmy G, they're full of chokers too. All right, so you face another choking team in the Super Bowl, and you guys lucked up into a Super Bowl win. Congratulations. Okay, it's not happening again. It's not happening again. Teams are getting healthier. Like I said, Big Ben is fully healthy now. Okay, that Steelers defense can lock up your offense. Okay, so you know overall, man, like, the Chiefs are a joke. The Chiefs are a joke. Okay, you guys will be lucky to win 10 games this year. Okay, like I said, there's two teams in your own division that's better than y'all. Okay, now you guys might still win more games than the Chargers just because Tyrod Taylor, he's just not a type of quarterback that's going to put points up on a consistent basis. Okay, so I'll give you that. But at the end of the day, Drew Lock is coming, and he's going to win more games than the Kansas City Chiefs. For real. You guys want no smoke with the Denver Broncos. And another thing is, with the possibility of there being no fans in the crowd this year due to this crazy year that's going on and everything that's going on around the world, let's say if there's no fans this year, then you guys are definitely not making the playoffs. Because I got news for you. One of the reasons that the Kansas City Chiefs have always been have been competitive is because they're playing Arrowhead. And you guys have a good home field. You take that home field advantage away, that reduces the chances of the home games that you guys usually win. So, you know, overall, man, you guys better hope that they allow fans back into the stadium this year. Or you guys might be lucky to win 8 games. Okay, you guys might not be able to win 8 games next year if there's no fans in the crowd. So, you know, overall, man, your team isn't good. Okay, you got the good coach. You got a good offensive mind coach. You got a top 5 quarterback. You got some, you know, receiving options around him. And you got 2 pass rushers. That's it. Okay. That's pretty much our entire team. I don't want to hear nothing about Clyde Edwards, the rookie that y'all drafted. We got to see him perform before we start calling him Brian Westbrook 2.0. Okay, Damian Williams is really not that good. You guys should have kept Kareem Hunt. Because I know what Chiefs fans are going to say, well, he lied to us, and he shouldn't have kicked the girl, and that was messed up, and you just can't, he can't hit females, domestic violence, win. I don't want to hear nothing. That's some of the biggest bullshit I ever heard since, listen, bro, you guys have Tyreek Hill on your team. Y'all have Tyreek Hill on your team. Tyreek Hill plays for the Kansas City Chiefs. Tyreek Hill is a terrible person. Terrible person. Bad person. Okay? You guys traded for Frank Clark from my Seahawks. You guys traded for Frank Clark. Okay? How are you guys going to trade for Frank Clark and release Kareem Hunt? When Kareem Hunt didn't even do what the Frank Clark did. All Kareem Hunt did was kick a chick, man. All he did was kick the female. Frank Clark is out here, you know, punching females, this and the third. So, you know, overall, y'all two-faced. Y'all two-faced. All right, so y'all, you know, listen, the Chiefs are just a disgrace. Disgrace of an organization. Okay, you guys better hope that Patrick Mahomes can stay healthy, because I got news for you. Okay, that Patrick Mahomes lower leg injury, it wasn't that big of a deal last year, but lower leg injuries, they can at times linger. They can. So, you know, overall, you guys better hope that Patrick Mahomes still got a good 5-10 years left in him. Because it's not a promise. It's not. Okay, so, you know, overall, man, I don't want to hear nothing about these Chiefs. You guys aren't a good team. And you know what? Truth be told, I can make a case that the Las Vegas Raiders are better than the Chiefs as a team overall. For real. You know, not just looking at quarterback, not just looking at the receiving options, just looking at the team overall. Josh Jacobs is better than any running back on your team. The Raiders got better offensive line because, truth be told, the Kansas City Chiefs really don't have a good offensive line outside of Mitchell Schwartz and maybe Eric Fisher. You got two good tackles. Outside that, your offensive line is straight garbage. Okay, so the Raiders got top five offensive line. You guys maybe got the pass rushing, but the Raiders got a solid pass rush themselves because they got Max Crosby and they drafted that rookie, and what's his name, Clint Farrell, last year. He's going to probably develop into a better pass rusher this year. They got way better linebacker play. The Chiefs linebacker play is straight garbage. It's straight ass. It's the bottom of my foot. It's the gum on the bottom of my foot. Okay? It's the gum on the bottom of my shoe. The Chiefs linebacker core is garbage. Okay? While the Raiders are rolling out Corey Littleton and the other free agent that they signed from the Bears. So, you know, overall in the secondary is a wash because the Chiefs don't have a good secondary themselves. I don't hear nothing about Breland and Ward. Okay, Tyrann Mathieu is overrated. I like the Raiders' safeties better because Johnny Abram, he's going to be a beast. Okay, they got Jeff Heath. So, you know, overall, man, like, I don't want to hear nothing. Okay, that Chiefs team isn't good. And they're going to fall straight on their faces. If you guys do make the playoffs, you guys are going to be an early first-round bounce. You guys are going to bounce in the first round. For real. I mean, this Chiefs team is a one-hit wonder. That's all the Chiefs are. You guys are a one-hit wonder. And that's going to show. Because unlike my Seahawks, when we are contenders every single year, you guys are going to fall straight back on your faces like the Kansas City Chiefs, who you are. Okay? The Kansas City Chiefs are a disappointing organization. And that's how it's going to be. So this is going to be the only ring. Last year is going to be the only ring that Patrick Mahomes and Andy Reid get. Okay, so I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope you guys celebrated. I hope you guys party. I hope you guys got drunk. I hope you guys ate all the barbecue that you guys have in Kansas City. And your barbecue really isn't that good to keep it a buck. Okay, I think Memphis has better barbecue. Okay, so you know, overall, Kansas City isn't worth nothing. Okay, OKC has fallen into the tank. The Oklahoma City Thunder aren't going to be good anymore. You know, Chris Paul is leading them to, you know, keeping them a contended team. But they're going to get rid of Chris Paul. And you guys are going to become a bottom feeder. I mean, nothing in Kansas City's gut, bro. Like, yuck. Okay, outside your college basketball team, nothing about Kansas is relevant, man. For real. Nothing. So, you know, overall, man, you know, y'all not worth nothing. Okay, you guys were down 24-0 to the Texans. If there was any other coach besides Bill O'Brien, you guys lose in the divisional round last year. So, you know, overall, I mean, the Chiefs lucked up to a Super Bowl. Lucked up and were lucky that they faced a team like the 49ers, who has a coach who can't hold a lead to save their lives, and got to face Jimmy G, and didn't have to play a quarterback like, I don't know, Russell Wilson, Aaron Rodgers, because you guys weren't beating the Packers. Okay, you guys, if the Packers were going to meet the Chiefs in the Super Bowl last year, you guys wouldn't have beat the Packers. You guys wouldn't have beat my Seahawks led by Russell Wilson in the Super Bowl. It just wouldn't have happened. Okay, so you know, overall, I hope you guys enjoyed it because Drew Lock is coming to take that AFC West crown, and you guys better hope that you guys can secure the number 2 seed. But that's it. That's all I want to speak about when it comes to these Kansas City Chiefs. You guys are a waste of my time, waste of space. It's a waste of energy speaking about Patrick Mahomes, okay? Like I said, he's not the best quarterback in the league. It's Russell Wilson, hands down. Okay, our defense is garbage, okay? Chris Jones is not better than Grady Jarrett. He's not better than Fletcher Cox. He's overrated himself. He can't stop the run. So, you know, overall, the Chiefs are just one big overrated team, okay? But y'all know what time it is. All Chiefs fans, you fat fucking Andy Reid, light-skinned Patrick Mahomes, domestic violence, Tyreek Hill, and Frank Clark, y'all go up in the front, all right? Y'all go up in the front, put a smile on your face, say cheese, open wide, and take these motherfucking shots.
Shout out my Crips, they're still crippin', nigga. Shout out my Bloods, they're still bloodin', nigga. Straight from the dirt, shout out my muddy niggas. Came from the bottom, all my get money niggas.
When I die, you ain't got to cry, you just got to pray. Put some weed where I lay, I'ma see you another day. Feeling energy, you my enemy, you got to pay. Was on the east side, fucking with them Crips the other day. Was on the west side.